It's the NFL on EA Sports, where we'll see which conference reigns supreme today. It's the Indianapolis Colts and the Minnesota Vikings under the lights on Sunday night.
Here in the north, the Yaller horn is about to sound and send two teams to battle here at U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, Minnesota. Welcome to another entertaining matchup, folks. Kate Scott, Brock Huard on the call in this one. Brock, a couple running backs down on the field who can really take over their offenses when they get in the groove.
And I think that's going to be the ultimate goal of both of these offenses, right? I mean, there's just no confusion about it. They want to get their bell cow in that groove. Find that rhythm where they're ripping off chuck yardage, run after run, and then just keep on feeding that beast. In a game like this, whichever offense can get that rhythm and run game going first, it's likely going to be your winner.
Before going down. So out come the Colts for their first offensive possession, bringing them out to fourth overall pick, who unfortunately ran that rookie season cut short at just four games. Good to have him back from Florida, Anthony Richardson.
Well, injury, well, it robbed all of us, Kate, and I mean all of us, from watching the development of Anthony Richardson. Such an unbelievable, unique skill set. As big and strong as any quarterback in this league. And if he took last year's experience of watching Gardner Minshew, just watching a pro go to work, if he took that experience with this skill set, then the sky is the limit.
Straight to the air is Richardson. And the connection not quite there yet on his opening throw of the game. No luck finding his receiver that time. So second down coming up. Cashman. Only a yard from that time, so now third and nine. And the shotgun, it's Richardson. Ready for the punt. Brandon Powell on the return for the Vikings. Fair catch called for, and he's got it right near the 30-yard line. So here come the Vikings taking the field for their first drive of the game. And we'll get a look at their signal caller playing in his seventh season.
Sam Darnold's seen an awful lot in his career. Now he's hoping the fourth time is an actual charm. After being a first-round pick, it seems like eons ago for the New York Jets, the guy's experienced a ton of football. And I'll say this, he went into one of the great QB incubators there with Kyle Shanahan in San Francisco. And now we'll all get a chance to see how much he really did learn, how much he really did grow. He is still young in his career. And with the supporting cast in Minnesota, a pretty dynamic receiver on the outside. He's got some nice tools to work with.
And he's brought down after a nice gain and a first down. Man in motion here. First carry here for Aaron Jones. And the push forward doesn't get beyond the line. Zaire Franklin there to make the tackle. No gain there that time, and it's second and 10. Throwing here, Darnold. Pass is caught by Addison. And he has it up towards midfield before he's taken down at the 47. So now here's third and five. Now Darnold. The Vikings getting their punt team out. Josh Downs deep for the Colts. The Indianapolis offense headed out for their second drive of the game. They didn't start the game off like they wanted, Brock. Still searching for that opening first down as they take the field a second time. Start out with a first and 10. Taylor gets it to begin the drive. And he found some running room for a nice gain. Pickup of 8 on the run, and that sets up second and 2. Set up at the 35 now. Taylor gets it on first and 10. Runs into traffic and hits a wall. No gain. That tackle made by Blake Cashman. Second and 10. Need to get some positive yardage here. Shotgun snap now to Richardson. Has him on the quick hitter. It's a pickup of 11. And it's good for an Indianapolis first down.
This running back is a mismatch maker. That's how I label him on my little sheet right here. Right under his bio, this guy just creates matchup nightmares for every defender on the field.
Thought he had the timing down and could make the play, but just a hair too early. So they'll only need 5 now after that neutral zone infraction penalty. Looking from the gun, it's Richardson. Kittman's got it. And he'll cross the 50 and start pushing onto the opposing side of the field.
Every once in a while, it's fine to be conservative on first down, especially when you get enough to stay on schedule and get a little something coming out of it, too.
After a good pickup, they're set up with second and short. Lone back in the backfield, and they give it to him. And he's tackled with a first down yardage.
That was the perfect play call for that particular situation. Gave him enough to pick up a first with some room to spare.
They'll head up first and 10 from the 42. Richardson back to throw. That one falls to the turf. Couldn't hang on. It's incomplete. He can't hang on to the pass. And it sets up second down.
Pretty easy to see here. He just simply takes off before he gets full possession, and that is a drop. It's kind of like when a receiver gets a handoff. You got to secure the ball first before you can make anything else happen.
Second and 10. Again, it's Richardson. Fits stopped at the 17-yard line. They got 24 yards on the play. And it'll be first down, Colts.
If they get a handful of these types of plays per game, pass game coordinator is going to be one happy camper.
A new set of downs awaits them. Here's first and 10. Working inside the red zone. Chased out to his right. He's going to keep it this time. And that's good yardage with a new set of downs.
I can tell you what, that was the goal from the moment he took off. Kept his eyes locked on the chains and made sure he set them up with a new set of downs. Well done.
This offense in position now. It's first and goal. Now Richardson to throw. Escapes out to the left. And he will score. Touchdown, Indianaplis. The Colts go up 6-0 here in the first. It's an Anthony Richardson touchdown. Just a great effort there from Imbrock to take it upon himself, embrace the initiative, and turn that drive into six.
You know, Kate, there was a day when you were watching Steve Young or Randall Cunningham, and that felt like a bonus touchdown. But that's not today. It feels like every quarterback's got to be able to score, be a dual threat on the ground. It's part of an offense every single team relies upon.
Matt Gay on for the extra point. Right down the middle, it's good. And the Colts will jump out to a 7-0 lead. Sanchez has it all set for the kickoff. It's Brandon Powell with the return. Finds some space. He's past the 30. And it's a nice return here. They'll tackle him shy of the 35. Minnesota all set to go for its second drive. And they're certainly hoping for some better results here after that first drive ended in a punt. Here's first and 10 from the 34. Here's Darnold to throw. Bails out of the pocket quick. Stepping up and he's going to run. And as they bring him down, let's check the penalty flag. A game they were pretty happy with goes away via the penalty. And now we're going to wait to see how they respond. Double the distance to go after that holding call. It's now first and 20. Darnold now to throw. It was there, but he couldn't hang on. That's incomplete. No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down. Now he'll throw off the play fake. Flush down out to his left. He's keeping it. Decent yardage picked up here before he slides down to avoid the tackle.
This is one of those occasions that it looks so promising when you take off as a quarterback, and then you're reminded just how fast these defenses are in the NFL. Couldn't quite move the chains, but it wasn't for a lack of trying.
Third and long for him here. That's going to fall incomplete. Either way, he was breaking it up. Couldn't hang on to the pick, so hits the ground, brings up fourth down.
I think I could see his eyes from the booth. He was envisioning the return and simply dropped it. You got to secure the pick before anything else.
On again comes Ryan Wright for another punt. He broke 50 on his first punt and looks to have done the same here. And he'll have this fair catch right along the 25. So no return on that punt. And the Colts will take over. Here comes the Colts offense now for another possession. And their goal is going to be doubling that 7-0 lead they have so far. Offense ready to begin this drive, first and 10. Richardson now. Running right side. And that's good for a gain of 5. Ivan Pace able to make the stop. All right, here we go. Second down. From the 31. Gets this one to Pierce. And that's good yardage there with a new set of downs to boot. Let's see how they attack this first down, Brock, from the 43. Play action with Richardson. That's incomplete. The aggressiveness there, like that, but couldn't connect. Second down.
Hey, Kate, you feeling lucky? Well, quarterback is, because he just dodged a major turnover. That was an easy pick that was simply dropped.
Couldn't connect on first. It's second down. They'll throw again. Richardson. Hauled in by Downs. Let's see what they draw up on third and 7. Throwing now, Richardson. And that's caught for the first. And they get this down to the 44 before he stopped. They get an even 10 on that play. And it's good for an Indianaplis first down.
You know, they call that the money down for a reason, because you're just simply not going to last long in the NFL if you don't convert a good portion of your third downs. It's the money down. And nice to see them roll the dice and continue the series.
On the 44-yard line now, first and 10. Throwing it again here. That one was incomplete. Couldn't hang on through the contact.
See the pass, time up your hit, and jar that ball loose. Not a lot of players are hanging on through a well-placed hit like that one.
So after the incompletion, here comes the second down call. Richardson. He throws a bullet deep to the right. He's got it inside the 10. And that play is brought to a halt, so they're going to say, at the 5-yard line. They rip off a big chunk of field, and it sets them up with first and goal.
One thing we don't have in football is we don't have that radar gun. But if we did, Kate, this is the kind to throw. When you throw it that deep outside the numbers, that requires a serious fastball, serious arm strength, and he just showed it off.
Big play sets him up pretty here with first and goal from the 5. They'll try and punch it in, and he drives into a pile of defenders and is stopped right at the line. Nothing doing that time, and it leaves them on second and goal.
You know, Kate, these are the situations in training camp that I love more than anything to watch. You learn so much about a football team in these goal-to-go situations. You know you got to protect that goal line, and the defense, well, it did the job on first down, more to come.
The shot to the end zone is incomplete. Thought he had a touchdown there, and now it'll be third and goal.
Man, that ball looked good out of his hands. It just couldn't get through the defense cleanly. Somebody tips it away and saves a potential completion.
So now, here's third and goal. From the shotgun, it's Richardson. Here's pressure, he's caught by the Vikings. And the pressure drives them backwards.
I know we talk about rhythm a lot when it comes to music, but it's the same thing with the quarterback and his protection. This QB was in rhythm, but they knocked the notes out of him on that one.
Fourth down's gonna bring out Matt Gay and the Colts field goal unit for the first time. This only a chip shot from the right hash. And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And this one is center chains. Couldn't have hit that much better.
Anytime you start sniffing that red zone and you don't score six, you only come away with 3 points. Not what you're looking for on the call sheet.
Sanchez has it all set for the kickoff. Ty Chandler to return. He stopped on the return at the 27. The Vikings offense back to the field now. And it's far from the first time we're seeing this unit head out, Brock. But what we haven't seen so far in this opening half, well, we haven't seen much in terms of yardage.
No, it's like they've written a few lyrics, but nowhere close to a song yet.
They're out and set, first and 10. Hands it to the receiver here in motion. Oh, look at this sweep. And he'll get taken down after advancing this to the 37.
It just feels like anytime this guy touches the ball, it's a big play waiting to happen. He could be lined up wide or when they use him as a runner. If someone doesn't get a hand on him quick, he's gone.
Let's see what they want to do here, partner. It's second and inches. From the 37. As a man, Justin Jefferson. That's a 38-yard play for him to move the sticks.
I love everything about that play, Kate, so much for a quarterback. When you're throwing that crossing route, it's imperative that you lead that receiver. You don't throw where he's at. You throw where he's going, and when you do, yards after catch follow.
Sets him up nice and pretty at the 25 following that big play. First and 10, here's Jones. And he breaks even, but that's it. Brought down at that line of scrimmage. Zaire Franklin there to make the tackle. No progress on first down, and that'll bring up second and 10. So before they can set up for another play, we've hit the end of the first quarter. It's a two-score game early. More from U.S. Bank Stadium after the break. We're ready now for the second quarter to begin. Vikings in control of it. They have it second down, well inside of field goal range. And this is pushed ahead for a gain of 5. Play made by EJ Speed. Here's 5 on that play. They need 5 more now on third down.
You know, Kate, one of the reasons it's so hard to run the ball in the NFL is to move grown men off their spot against their will. You get a run play like that, you've done your job. You've moved them against their will, and you've set yourself up for some later success.
Short throw is dropped. This one's incomplete.
Well, you certainly want those throws to be automatic. Every team, if you're going to be efficient, you got to hit those passes in the short to intermediate zone to effectively move the ball in this league.
So the Vikings will try a field goal on fourth down. Will Reichert head it out? This is going to be a 38-yarder from the right hash. And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. That'll bring it back to within a score. The lead 7.
You always feel like you're
just like that, we're back to a one-possession ball game as the kickoff is away. Josh Downs to return it. He stopped on the return at the 27. The Indianapolis offense ready to take another swing at it. And the last drive did end in points. Not as many as they wanted, though. They had to settle for that field goal despite advancing the football pretty well. Drive starts out with a first and 10. Off the play fake, here's Richardson. Flushed out of the pocket. He tucks it and takes off. And he'll be met near the line to limit the gain to a yard. Jonathan Fuller with the stop.
That's just a case where you're trying to make something when there really is nothing there. There just wasn't an opening for him to work with, and he was lucky to get what he could.
They'll come to the line here, second and 9. To throw, Richardson finds him over the middle, and he gets him around 6 there. That tackle made by Blake Cashman. Third and 4 coming up now. Shotgun snap now to Richardson. He was looking for Michael Pittman Jr. And 4th and 4 coming up.
Defensive coaches in the NFL say it all the time. Limit the big play. Keep these guys in front of you. Well, this defense is going to have to stay vigilant because this receiver, he could take the lid off the defense at any time.
And he can't evade the coverage team for much. They stop him before he gets really anything on that return. Officially a 55-yard launch. And it's going to be Vikings football. They'll get this drive started. 1st and 10. Fakes the handoff. Now to throw. Locates Jefferson along the sideline. Complete. And he takes this out after crossing the 45. They get 20 yards out of the play and move the chains.
Part of the reason I leave you pregame, Kate, and get down to that field and watch these guys throw and catch is I want to see their timing. I want to see their anticipation. That is picture perfect right there. A crossing route thrown that quickly tells me these two are on the same page.
Great start to the drive. They're up in the neighborhood of midfield after just one play. Now Darnold has him on the quick hitter. And he gets it through the midfield stripe and onto the Colts side of the field.
That is the epitome of staying on schedule. That kind of completion right there on first down. Well, it opens up the entirety of the playbook for second down. On the 3rd and short in your back pocket, you can get even more aggressive and take that shot.
Slot man motioned over. 2nd and 3. He beams one deep right side. This is caught inside the 15. And he drives this forward to the 6. They rip off a big chunk of field, and it sets him up with 1st and goal.
Well, that's sure one way to take the lid off of defense. Great work to find the biggest hole in the coverage, and more importantly, go exploit it.
Four downs now to get in. Here's 1st and goal. Now run here with Jones. And he gets them a little closer to the end zone, down to the 6. Doing just 1 yard, I think, on the run. Still some work to do here on 2nd and goal. Another try for Jones. Once again, he doesn't manage much before getting brought down. It's a gain of two, and now they have third and goal at the three.
We're getting a little bit closer, but you can feel the pressure starting to mount. Unless you're committed to playing four downs here, this becomes a critical third down call.
Shotgun now on third down. Ooh, that looked like a pick for a second, but it hits the end zone grass. They are very fortunate to get this one back, but now they've got fourth down.
Oh, that was such an opportunity lost. They were looking for a way out without giving up any points on the series. And instead, well, he just couldn't quite hang on.
And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And it's dropped back down now to a four-point game.
In that close, in the red zone, you know they're upset. They couldn't finish the drive with a touchdown. It's only half the points, but at least there's something to show for the possession.
The lead to four as they send it away. Downs on the return. Good looking return here, and he's got room. They'll bring him down on the return as he gets this to the 33. Now the Indianapolis offense heading out. They were only on the field for three plays their prior series, Brock. Let's see what changes they make to take over here.
Listen, these defenders in the league today, you throw a ball deep down the field like that, it turns into a 50-50 ball. More times than not, they can make a play and take it away, just as they did.
So good field position to start with for the Vikings this drive, first and 10. They'll send him over right. And the receiver's gonna take this one on the jet sweep. And this is a nice gain. It's stopped at the 47. Call it 9 yards. Looked like a first for a moment. It's second and one.
That's just a good play to mix up what you're doing and keep that defense guessing. The execution, that's pretty well done too, creating the space for a solid pickup.
Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and one. Running right, this is Jones. The defenders are there to get him at the line. Play made by EJ Speed. Nothing for them on second down, and now it's third and one.
Hey, I know third and one feels like an automatic running down, but after seeing that last play yield you nothing, this offense and that coordinator's got a seat of doubt. This defense playing some mind games with them.
Looking to throw on third and one. Pass his man. It's Addison. He finds him 16 yards and a new set of downs. Still on the move. Coming to the line for first and 10. Off the play fake, he's gonna throw. Connects with his back, Aaron Jones. He's contained at the line for no gain. Play made by EJ Speed.
You know, I've learned over the years, defensively they call that the camera club. How many different guys can get rallying to the football? So that last shot you see on camera, you see as many defenders keeping that to a zero-yard gain. That's well done defensively.
Second and 10 now.
I don't know about you, Kate, but I think somebody's auditioning for some extra work as a receiver. If he can do that coming out of the backfield, imagine the damage he could do if they sent him out into one of those spots out wide.
Big play got him to the doorstep, Brock. Four more yards now and goal to go. Jones. And he's just spinning his wheels, man, this entire first half. They drop him behind the line.
Well, once we saw them on a collision course with one another, we know how inertia works. The bigger man, he wins.
After the loss, it's second and goal from the five. Staying on the ground with Jones. And he's still looking for the play that sparks the ground game as that one stopped for a loss.
This coordinator tried to show some trust and belief in his offense. A run after a negative run? Well, you lose a lot of equity and belief in that coordinator. I don't think he's going to try a third run after back-to-back negative losses.
Third down from the gun. Has it down close. And he's out of bounds at the three. Nearly got to the end zone there. So the Vikings will try a field goal on fourth down. Will Reichert head it out? This is a chip shot from the left hash. And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And that cuts the lead back down to a lower point.
And then the first half trifecta. He's 3 for 3 on field goals. As much as they like 6 points in drive, not three, they must be happy with the consistent inside field goal range. He's delivering.
Things trim back down to a single point, Brock, as they send this off and away. Downs on the return. His return makes it up to the 25. The Colts are ready to take the field. And this drive, Brock, hopefully longer than that last one. They were only out there one play before they were picked off.
You kind of a good chance right now to see how risk-averse these guys are offensively. A lot of game left. They could give the passing game a little breather and start this one on the ground.
The drive will start out with a first and 10. Looking to throw here and shake off that previous INT. And the Vikings rush, brings him down. And a big play drives them backwards. Second down coming up.
That right there is one of the biggest differences between the NFL and college game. Head to high school and pop on the game. Because when you break away from a sack at those lower levels, big things happen. But at this level, this big boy league, just because you get out of one guy's arms doesn't mean you're safe anytime soon.
Everyone's prepped. It's second down now. Another try following the sack. Short pass brought in. And he's up across the 20 before going out of bounds. This drive in some serious trouble. It's third and 12. Back to throw. Here's Richardson. Called in by Downs. And they take him down at the 24-yard line.
You've got to be cognizant of where the line to gain is. You can't run that route short, and you certainly can't throw it. That route's just not deep enough. Need to extend it closer to the chains for a first down.
Another punt coming up for Rigoberto Sanchez. And he's certainly been staying busy. Once again, he's out to punt and sends this flying. And that fair catch corralled just beyond the 25-yard line. We don't get a return out of that punt. And it's going to be their football coming up. Offense ready to begin this drive. First and 10. Man in motion out of the slot. Starting the drive with a give to Jones. And he gets up for a gain of about 4. So it's the 2-minute warning here from Minneapolis. It's the Vikings. With 2nd and 6. From the 32. He's gonna try to drop it in deep right. And disaster averted. He knocks away the deep ball, incomplete. That one firmly denied by the man in coverage. And that makes it 3rd down.
You know, ball skills are not just a selling point for receivers entering the draft. Teams want defenders, especially in this day and age of the passing game, who can make plays on the ball too, especially on these deeper throws. He doesn't swat that one away. We could be looking at a huge game.
He's gone, that's Addison. And he'll push this upfield and earn them a new set of downs. Vikings out of the hurry up, need everyone back to the line. Darnold. Jefferson brings it in on the slant. And he drives this across midfield and down into enemy territory. Vikings out of the hurry up, need everyone back to the line. 2nd and 4. Bails out of the pocket quick. He takes it himself. It's a great pickup, 16 yards, and now they've got 1st down.
Well, there was no sense in taking a risk down the field when a 1st down was just a run away. They'll get to reset now and figure out just how they want to attack a new set of downs.
Ball at the 33 for 1st down. Throwing here, Darnold. An alert play defensively there. He got a hand on it to tip it away. That makes it 2nd down.
I think you're seeing why they like this guy in coverage, man. He reacts well to throws and is so adept in breaking up passes right through contact or before they ever reach the target.
No dice on that prior pass. Here's 2nd down. To throw. Here's Darnold. Pass is caught by Addison. And he'll be brought down here at the 23-yard line. The Vikings call a timeout. It'll be their 1st. They'll have 2 left to work with before halftime. Third down, 1 yard to go. Here's Darnold to throw. Caught out left. Just a couple of yards here as he heads to the sideline. Pickup of 2 here. And that's going to get the Vikings the 1st down. He'll throw it yet again. The connection to Jones. And he'll go down here at the 16. Minnesota spends its 2nd time out here. And they still have 1 in their pocket for what's left of this half. After a good pickup, they've got 2nd and 4. From the 16. Has him on a quick hitter. And that'll be enough for the 1st as they touch him down. Now a timeout taken by the offense, and we're going to see see if they try for two plays here or just try the field goal right now. He brings the offense up now for a first and 10. Darnold now to throw. And this one falls incomplete, so we're down to 4 seconds, and we'd assume our final snap. Only time left for one more snap, Brock, so they're going to run out their field goal unit. High percentage look for him here from the left hash. And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And that's going to give them a lead.
I know you always want to finish drives in the end zone, but no matter what, the important thing is they end in some kind of points. And that's mission accomplished there.
Turn good as it's away. The turn starts from the goal line. He's hauled down on what is the final play of our first half. So we've reached halftime in Minneapolis with the Vikings out in front at the break. Now we'll send you south to our Orlando studios for the EA Sports Halftime Report with Jonathan Coachman.
Okay, Kate, thanks very much. And with that, we welcome you all into our EA Sports studios. This is the Halftime Report. These two teams heading out of the tunnel, and we're ready to get back to it. For the call of the second half, here is the great Kate T. Scott. Kate?
As always, a hat tip to Coach for his hard work during the break, as we're happy to welcome y'all back for the start of our third quarter. Sanchez has it all set for the kickoff. Powell now to return. Coverage team gets him down at the 26-yard line. The Vikings and Sam Darnold headed out for their next shot on offense. They're out and set, first and 10. They give to Jones, right side. Gets it ahead, has about 5 yards. Brought down by Julian Blackman. Give him 5 on that carry, bring it up 2nd and 5.
And don't need to worry about third down at all.
First and 10 from the 41. Now he'll give up the middle to Jones. And he'll be brought down after getting to the 47-yard line. And that one goes for a gain of 11. And it'll bring up a Minnesota first down.
Now, don't think for a second they're going to slow down the tempo. Defense on their heels. And right now is the best chance to go push that envelope and get aggressive.
Play action on first down. He rolls to his right, trying to get away from the pressure, but he can't, and they drop it. And the big play drives them backwards. 2nd down coming up.
Wow, it has been such a good day offensively for the guys up front. That's actually the first sack by this defense And now comes the real question mark. Will it lead to more, or will this offense learn a lesson and get back to the rhythm they've been in protecting?
Offense to the line for second down. Jones trying left side. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
This offense may want to try and disguise their run a little bit. I don't know if it's the old lineman's stance. I don't know if it's a cadence. I don't know what it is. But after two straight plays going backwards, this defense is all over it.
This offense looking to convert as they come up on third down. Here's Darnold. Throwing the out route complete. And he goes out. Just needed one more step there to reach midfield.
That's just discipline with a capital D. The play in the huddle is a running back screen, but it takes discipline for that offensive line to not get downfield. Discipline for that receiver to stay alert, stay aware that he's a viable option as well.
Punt team is on now, and they get this away. And this one did hit at the 8, but took a big bounce and finished its journey in the end zone for a touchback. The Colts offense set to head out. Their last drive didn't make it very far before they had to punt it away, partner, so hopefully this one has some better legs to it. Drive starts out with a 1st and 10. Option gives to Taylor. And he found some running room for a nice gain. Call it 7 yards, and now they'll have 2nd down and 3. Shotgun snap now to Richardson. That one falls to the turf. Couldn't hang on. It's incomplete. Looks like a bit of a concentration drop on that one. And now they'll face a 3rd and 3.
You know, I'm not sure if he was hearing footsteps or just had a surprise break in concentration. So unusual to see one dropped unless there's a hit involved.
3rd and short yardage here, Richardson. Complete beyond the marker. And he'll go down after fighting his way to the 32. Pick up a 5 on that play. And it'll be 1st down, Colts.
You're not going to last long in the National Football League if you don't convert a good chunk of your 3rd downs. Nice find there to continue the series.
Running right, this is Taylor. And he finds space for about a 3-yard gain. That tackle made by Blake Cashman. Give him a few yards on that run. It's 2nd and 7. Musters up 3 yards on the run. That sets up 3rd and 4. And the shotgun, it's Richardson. It was there, but couldn't hang on. That's incomplete. That's what he knows he should have had. 4th and 4 coming up. On now comes their punter. Rigoberto Sanchez will kick it away. Fair catch made a little beyond the 20-yard line. That punt goes unanswered. No return there. And it'll be their football. The Vikings now set to take the field. They didn't add to their lead last time out. They punted it away, but still ahead and able to add to it here. They'll get this drive started. 1st and 10. Drive starts with a quick throw left complete. was brought to a halt at about the 36-yard line. It's a pickup of 14 yards as the chains reset.
Nice to see that connection, that chemistry working between the two of them.
First down, ball at the 36. Straight ahead they go with Jones. And his effort results in maybe 2 yards, but nothing more. Eight yards to go. Let's see how they approach this second down. Jones wants more. And they'll make a stop up at the 46-yard line. 8 yards on the gain, and the drive continues forward.
That's the type of call that offensively, man, it just builds so much confidence. I don't even think they were looking to get the first down. Just get to a manageable third down, but instead they move the chains, and that is one disheartening look on that defense.
They go play action on first. Chains reset.
I may love watching a great thrower, but I love watching a well-done route too, Kate. Make that guy think you're trying to stack him only to drop your hips and cut right inside. Some good work to help reset those chains.
They're now set for first and 10. On the carry, this is Jones. It looks like we can call it about 4 yards in the end. Brought down by Julian Blackman. Second and 6 coming up here. It's Jones on the toss. And he's able to get this down to the 13. A 70-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
That's what I call a healthy return on investment. You run the toss play, looking for positive yards, looking to move the sticks, and I'm looking for that to be called again.
A new set of downs forthcoming. It's first and 10. From the red zone now. The throw is caught. And he's short of the first after a mile gain.
He's just one of those guys, Kate. Even when he's not open, he's still a target thanks to that physicality and his ability to just play bully ball. They don't like forcing into coverage, but sometimes when you got a bully like him that can create space, you just find a way to get him the ball.
Second down carry for Jones. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains.
Most of the people watching will forget about that play in a couple minutes, but the coaches won't forget. He has that filed away the next time he really needs to pick up a few yards.
They'll break the huddle and come up on first and goal. Jones. And he sneaks this through the middle, maybe a gain of 2. Now it's second and goal from the 1. Now a give to Jones. And he's in for the touchdown. The Vikings push this to an 8-point game. It's an Aaron Jones touchdown. It's Will Reichert on for the extra point. extra point set right down the middle. And the Vikings push the lead to two scores now. Set to kick this away. Has this at the six. And this return gets to the 30 before he stopped. Another drive coming up for this offense. And I'm sure they're tired of bringing out the punter, Brock. They're hopefully going to give him some rest this time around and find some points to go after that lead. First and 10 now from the 30. Working from the gun, it's Richardson. And a big play drives them backwards. Second down coming up.
Okay. I think we know that the quarterback's a demanding position because not only do you have to have a clock in your head, but you've got to have a spatial awareness of where you are on the field. And once you start retreating, going backward and backward and backward, you got to just sling the ball in the stands. Otherwise, you take a huge negative sack like that.
Let's see what they dial up on a second and very long. Another try following the sack. He completes it in traffic. And it's a nice game, but still not enough for the first.
I think the defense is still turned around looking for where the ball is. Is that QB and tight end? They got that ball out in a hurry.
It's a dime look by the Vikings. Third down coming. Back to throw. Here's Richardson. That one falls to the turf. Couldn't hang on. It's incomplete. It was there. Just couldn't corral. This is going to be his fourth effort tonight. And he sends this away. Definitely his best kick of the game thus far. And the coverage team is there as he fields it. So almost nothing on that return before he stopped. The Vikings and Aaron Jones headed back out there on offense. They'll try to emphasize what worked on their last drive, which ended, Brock, in a touchdown. And the drive will start out with a first and 10. Going with Jones on the ground. And he scampers ahead and gets two on the carry.
That's a pretty good stop on first down. This defense now gets a chance to dictate. And that's what all the great defenses want to do, Kate. They want to dictate it on their terms and not just be reacting to what the offense is always doing.
8 yards to go. Well, let's see how they approach this second down. Out of the gun and give to Jones. Escapes a defender. And he got it real close, but stopped just about a yard or so shy of that first down. Battle coming up on third and inches. Throwing now off play action. Sunday night. It's Vikings ball working to carry this lead through to the end. First down now, ball at the 39-yard line. Throwing off the play fake here. On the move, hit it right. And he slides down. We'll see what the business is with this penalty flag. This could be coming back. So the refs get him for holding, and that's going to back this offense up. Running it after the penalty. And they're going to stop him after he wiggles his way forward for two. Back to the line they go. It's second down. Darnold looking to throw. This one's quickly to Jones. And he made a bid for midfield there, but stopped at his own side at the 49.
Okay, I know exactly what's going to happen. I've seen it once, I've seen it 100 times. Next week on the practice field, this running back's going to say, "See, I'm not just a running back. I can play receiver. And you receivers, you couldn't do my job, but I just showed you I could do yours."
Third down, here's Jones. And he's brought down for a loss.
You felt it the second this play bounced toward the outside, this defense responded. They pounced. That was their chance to get to him before he could get the couple inches he needed for a first down.
Minnesota lined up in punt formation. Ryan Wright's the one to send it away. Averaging a little under 50 a kick so far, Brock, as he gets away another one. And he's there to make the fair catch right at the 10-yard line. This offense getting all set for this series. And this game might be going better if he could have some more time just to work back there. This pass rush has been all over them, really keeps taking this offense out of any grooves that they've managed to get into.
Okay, I like to say in life, there's energy givers and there's energy vampires.
Yeah.
And for this defense, these sacks right here, they're such energy givers. And man, it's like a vampire sucking the juice out of an offense.
Yeah, I love that. Offense ready to begin this drive. First and 10. Richardson now. He's on the move. Now here he goes. And he's brought down. They're spotting this one right at the 20. Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and one. Pittman, the man in motion left. Second down carry for Taylor. And they take him down at the 24-yard line. They'll say he got five there, but Brock, all they care about is the first down that comes with it.
These aren't the plays that will lead highlight reels, but they're the ones that win you ball games. What a nice game by the back. And now his offense can go in any number of directions on first and 10.
First down, and they go right back to it. And the defense gets there to force a small loss. The rookie out of Alabama, they're on the tackle.
I know from the position of the quarterback, Kate, sometimes you hand that ball, you put it in the belly of the running back, and you send him right into the teeth of a buzzsaw. You can feel it from the jump, and that call from the defense, that came at the perfect time.
Here's second and 11. Fits it through the middle. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. 35 on the pickup. And it's good for an Indianaplis first down.
You throw it in the middle of the field, it's all about anticipation and accuracy. I mean, those are the two keys all the time in my book, Kate. But when you throw it in the middle of the field with all of the traffic, that's where guys with great anticipation and that tremendous accuracy come to life.
On first down, it's Richardson. Short throws, drops. This one's incomplete. Connect. sacked on first. It's second down. Now Richardson to throw. Escapes the pocket. He's on the move. And they bring him down. Looks like he got into the 27. They'll get 14 yards and a new set of downs.
I can promise you, that was the goal from the moment he took off. He kept his eyes locked on the chains. It's almost like he had a spidey sense. He knew exactly where to get in order to move the sticks and get that critical first down.
Richardson now on first and 10. He's on the move. He calls his own number again. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. They rip off a big chunk of field, and it sets him up with first and goal.
As much as you like to find a completion and get the ball out of your hands, when a play breaks down, you got to be able to make a play with your legs. His offense counts on his ability to evade pressure and occasionally make plays just like that.
First and goal. Here's Taylor. And they love to see him fighting forward, but he only gets him three. It's second and goal. Throwing now, Richardson. Buys time, roll. And he has the Indianaplis touchdown. The Colts have cut it to a three-point game here in the fourth. It's an Anthony Richardson touchdown. It's what every player who scores a touchdown wants to do, Brock. He wants to get right back there and put another six on the board.
I've never met an NFL player content with one end zone trip in a game.
Nope.
Yeah, if you're content, you're not making it to this league. You get one, you instantly think of another, and the fortunate few are able to actually deliver on it.
Gay to add the extra point. The point after splits the uprights. And the Colts cut the lead down to just two. Down to a two-point difference as they send the kick away. Chandler now on the return. And this drive will start inside the 25. The Vikings headed back out on offense. Their quarterback returning to the field now. They're out and set, first and 10. Starting the drive with a give to Jones. And his effort results in maybe 2 yards, but nothing more. Eight yards to go. Well, let's see how they approach this second down. Darnold now to throw. That's incomplete. Trying to set up the screen there. No connection on the last play. And now it's third down. Here's Darnold to throw. Escapes the pocket. He'll make a big play on the ground. And that's good yardage with a new set of downs. They're set up at the 35 now. First and 10. Here's Jones. And he sneaks this through the middle, maybe a gain of two. Eight yards to go. Let's see how they approach this second down. Counterplay, Jones. And once again, he doesn't manage much before getting brought down. They push it forward for a yard. That brings up third and eight.
Well, no springing a big play on that one. It's just going to simply be used as a setup play, whether that's another run or eventually what I love, setting up a play-action pass off that counter action.
Third and long for him here. He puts some air under this one, deep right. And he's able to send that one away, incomplete.
Any DB prefers a highlight reel interception to just forcing an incomplete pass. But as soon as he realized a pick wasn't possible on the play, he gets his hands on it and made sure it wasn't completed.
The Vikings getting their punt team out. And they could really use a good one here. And a fair catch made here at the 17. No return on that punt. And the Colts will take over. Their offense ready to take the field now. And the last time they had it, they ran it down the field on them. I'd expect some better resistance up front if they try that again. Drive starts out with a first and 10. Taylor gets it to begin the drive. And he's tackled after gaining a handful. First down play, that's in five. It's going to be second and five. Takes off right out of the read option. He breaks the tackle. And that tackle stops him after a solid gain. Caught 4 yards, and they're set up with a manageable third and two.
You know, gains that seem a little tougher to get against the front, gosh, this QB just makes routine. Such effortless running to pick up a handful in that designed run.
Third and just two to go. Option give to Taylor. He'll get them enough for a first down.
I think some of us watching that in real time might not have been sure, but he sure was. He knew exactly where he had to get for the first, and he popped right away, signaling that he had it.
They've got three timeouts and the 2-minute warning left for him. We've got first and 10. To throw, Richardson. Finds him over the middle. And this one's brought to a halt at the 36-yard line.
It's what you call efficiency. Exactly what you're looking for in first down. Textbook. It sets up second and very manageable, and then creates that space if you want to take a shot downfield.
It's the 2-minute warning here in Minneapolis. Colts trail by a couple. After a good pickup, they're set up with second and short. From the 36. Pittman's got it. And the tackle's made just beyond midfield at the 48. That play good for 17 and a first down.
I'm sure coach, a play caller doesn't mind making the job a little bit easier. You know, play calling's a lot simpler and easier when you count on the offense to move the chains on those early downs.
First and 10, ball set up at the 48. Now to throw. Finds a seam down the middle. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. trying the left side. And he stops. Now we need to hear what this flag is all about. The game they were pretty happy with goes away via the penalty. And now we're going to wait to see how they respond. And he's got a decent gain before being brought down. Minnesota spends its second time out here as they'll meet and decide what to do on this second down. Taylor again. And he's short of the first after a mild gain. Now the Vikings use their third and final timeout. And they'll take a moment to ponder what the call's going to be on third down. They go again with Taylor. He gets him the first inside the 15. An excellent gain, 20 yards there, and that's going to move the sticks.
Best run games in this league have balance. Can run it inside, and as they just showed right there, doing damage on the outside.
Well, they've certainly got the field goal in their back pocket. They're going to try for the touchdown first here and goal to go. Going to the ground again on first. And he won't get anything there. Several defenders nearby to hold him up. No gain that time, and now it'll be second and goal. Taylor. And they make a stop at the last minute. It's a gain down to the one. Given five on the run. Now it's fourth and goal.
This front, well, they've done a good job bending and not breaking. First down, didn't score. Second down, didn't score. And now third and goal. Can't find the end zone either.
And now we get a timeout from the Colts. That's their first. And they still have two available for them as we approach the end of this game. Spot. It's a chip shot. This one straight ahead. That one is good. And that, folks, is your game winner.
I know that was a kick he could make in his sleep, but with the game on the line, he delivered.
Sanchez has it all set for the kickoff. And he opts not to bring this one out, so they're going to enjoy some good starting field position from the 30. They'll get this drive started. First and 10. Throwing now. and he just gets rid of it. Knew he had a couple of plays left. Didn't want to take a risk there on first down. So after the incompletion, here comes the second down call. One final shot here. A bit of desperation on this deep shot. And this one falls incomplete. No miracles on the final drive today. This game is over. So it's the Colts who come away with a win on the road. And there was no easing up. It took some white knuckling until the very end, but their defense carried that small lead through to the finish line as they escape with a victory. Come on, Jordan.